Welcome to the next lecture. Today we will study random processes through LTI system. Before that, let me recall what we had in last lecture. We studied multiple random processes. Suppose we have two processes, x of t, y of t. They are two random processes. Just consider this as a generalization of you might have done multiple random variables. Okay. Now, when we have two random processes, we can talk of this thing that at time t1, I will take one sample function of x of t1, and at time t2, I will take another sample, one sample of y of t2, and then take its expected value, that is mean, which in the book also we write in this notation, something like this. Then this is called cross correlation, and its notation is rxy t1 t2. We also define that if this cross correlation, it depends only on the difference between t1 to t2, then we say that x and y are jointly stationary. Okay, jointly stationary. We also define correspondingly joint power spectral density. Okay, now today we are going to study one system. So you already are familiar with linear time invariant system. Okay, you have done the usual inputs, suppose unit step function, ramp function, sinusoidal function, which are passed through some system and you get y of t. As an example, amplifier is a system, right, where y of t is simply a times x of t. Similarly, oscillator is one such system, and there are several communication systems which can be modeled in this way, right? And for every system we have impulse response h of t. Now what if instead of a deterministic signal, right, suppose you have sine omega t as x of t, what if instead of sine omega t there is a random quantity also phase? So this is a random process. Now if input of the system is random process, how will the system behave? What will be the output? What will be the power spectral density of output corresponding input, so on so forth? Several such questions we want to address. So now our model will be, so here is a system with impulse response h of t and corresponding transfer function h of omega, which you know that h of t, h of omega, they form the Fourier transform pair, right? And here is the input random process x of t, output random process y of t. Now whether x of t, y of t, they are random processes or usual time varying functions, we know that output is equal to y of t, convolution of h of t and x of t. So convolution definition is integral. You know, usually you use this definition of convolution, you write h of tau y of t minus tau, right? But I want to reserve tau for some other purpose, so I will use any other dummy random variable. Suppose h of alpha y of t minus alpha d alpha minus infinity to infinity. So this is the output. Okay, so let me write the capital Y so that we are consistent with the notation. This is the random process. Now, you know, for computing, suppose we want to compute the autocorrelation function of output process, right? So for computing autocorrelation function, remember, you need to compute, you need to take value of function at two time instants, suppose y of t and y of t plus tau. Definitely we are assuming stationary processes, especially void sense stationary process, so that we only take care of the tau, you know, gap between the two processes time day. Anyways, so what will be y of t plus tau? Just replace here, so just replace t plus tau instead of t, so this is y of t plus tau. Now what is the definition of autocorrelation function of output process? So how do we write that? Auto correlation of output process, so that is notation r y of tau, right, is equal to expected value of y of t plus tau. Can go back to the lecture of autocorrelation, and this is the definition. We will now write the appropriate values, expected value of first integral. So this is y of tau. I will put it in one bracket. Now I need to write y of t plus tau. I will now, you know, write some steps which will look obvious to you, but they need some mathematical justification. But at this level, we will not go into that. So they need some justifications from a mathematical field called measure theory, okay, which is definitely beyond the scope of, you know, our even BTEC course. So what are those justifications? See, I will first of all do one thing. I will club up the internal terms and I will write double integral. So first integral for the left one, then second integral, okay, and then, oh, before that, a small typo. You know, for t plus tau, I will use different dummy variable here, let's say beta, okay. So that is important. We will use different dummy variable here, and hence here also we have beta, we have beta, and we have beta. So the first integral is with respect to alpha, the second integral is with respect to beta, okay. So this is for beta, and then I will write internal things, h of alpha and other terms. Now this clubbing of internal functions and writing it as a double integral, it also needs justification. And what is the justification? That justification is about the behavior of functions. It should be a nice function, continuous, and, you know, should have finite value, should not have infinite value, so on and so forth. We will not delve into those conditions. We assume that all our processes and h of t, they are nice functions such that this operation is allowed. Now I need to do one more operation. Now first of all, I will club up the terms. You see, x of t plus t minus alpha is a random process, so it is a random quantity. This is also a random process, whereas the system impulse functions h of alpha, h of beta, they are not random processes. So we will club up, we will do one thing. The expectation will be only over the random quantities, okay. So let me first write one more step. Now I have clubbed h of alpha, alpha, beta, h of alpha, alpha, h of beta together. So these are deterministic terms. Deterministic means they are not random quantities, they don't have probabilities, they are fixed values, whereas this is a random quantity. So expectation, we will do one thing, is called exchanging integral and expectation. That is something like this: expected value of x of t minus alpha and x of t plus tau minus beta, then d alpha d beta. Now this exchange of expectation and integral, taking expectation within the integral, this also is justification. Again, we assume that those justifications are satisfied. We will not delve into the details right now. Now what is this term? What is this? How does it look like? Okay, if you see and carefully look at it, see, we are assuming that this is our assumption, that x of t is wide sense stationary process, okay. What does that mean? I will repeat it again because it's a new thing for you. It means that the mean of x of t is constant, it is some constant, and the autocorrelation function. Now see, this is autocorrelation function, which is expected value of x of at time t1 at time t2. This is a function of t2 minus t1, okay. Now look at this. Here t1 is t minus alpha and t2 is t plus tau minus beta. So this is autocorrelation function of input process t2 minus t1, that is t plus tau minus beta, right, minus t minus alpha. So t and t will get cancelled out, and we can write autocorrelation as rx of tau plus alpha minus beta, right.
So I can write this integral as integral minus infinity to infinity, then again minus infinity to infinity h of alpha h of beta r x of tau plus alpha minus beta d alpha d beta. Now this can be simplified as, we can write it in another way. You just observe first one thing, that if we take h of tau, its convolution with rx of tau, okay? So we can write this as integral h of suppose beta rx of tau minus beta d beta. Now if we now take convolution with h of minus tau, that is we take convolution of this with h of minus tau, so then it will be double integral, okay? And because of this convolution with h of minus tau, we will have another h of alpha, then there is h of beta here, and we will have rx of tau minus beta minus of minus alpha, okay? Because we need to subtract the dummy random variable, sorry, dummy variable, so it will be double integral h of alpha h of beta rx of tau plus alpha minus beta, which is the same integral we got here, right? So it means that what we have got is the autocorrelation function of output can be written as h of tau convolution with h of minus tau convolution with, sorry, h of minus tau convolution with h of tau convolution with r x of tau. This is very important relation we have got. We can write it also as, you can verify it, h of tau, there is nothing wrong, h of minus tau convolution with h of tau, we'll get the same answer. This actually is what we should follow now onwards. And now what is the use of this equation? It's a very beautiful equation with respect to what? Power spectral density. So recall that power spectral density is Fourier transform of autocorrelation function, right? We take Fourier transform on both the sides. So we get Fourier transform of R y of tau is Fourier transform this whole thing, right? And you know that Fourier transform convolution of any two functions is just the product. So it will be Fourier transform of h of tau times Fourier transform of h of minus tau times Fourier transform of rx of tau. So Fourier transform of output autocorrelation is simply, I can write sy of omega, the output power spectral density. Fourier transform h of tau is a transfer function h of omega, and minus tau, you know that it is h conjugate of omega, right? And Fourier transform of input autocorrelation function is input power spectral density, right? And you know that complex times conjugate is mod of h of omega square sx of omega, and this is sy of omega. So we got this beautiful relationship that if you are given input process which is wide sensitivity, which has power spectral density as sx of omega, you are given the transfer function h of omega, you can get the output random outputs power spectral density of the system. Now one more important example of multiple random processes is where we may add two random processes. Suppose you have two processes, x of t, again y of t. Okay. I assume they are stationary, I mean at least wide sense stationary process. I again repeat orally, it means their mean is constant, their autocorrelation function depends only on the difference between the two time instants you sample the process. And let's suppose we add them and we get one more random process called z of t. So y of t is x of t plus z of t. This is very, very important process in communication system. You know, all the wireless channels, all the wireline channels, even optical fiber channels,
and almost 99% of communication systems, they behave like this. Suppose x of t can be input, y of t can be noise, z of t can be the output. So this is very important model. Now suppose we are given that x of t, which is a wide sense stationary random process, has autocorrelation function rx of tau, y of t has ry of tau. What will be the autocorrelation function of z of t? Okay, so we use the definition rz of tau. You know it is expected value of z of t plus tau. Okay, and we can write this as expected value of, instead of z we write x plus y. Okay, we just replace it with corresponding x plus y, and then we multiply the terms, we get these many terms. Okay, now I will take expectation over each of the term. You might have done expectation is linear operator, that is expected value of, you know, sum of two random variables is equal to sum of the expectations. Okay, so this is linear operator, so we will use that. We get, now we use definitions. You know, the first term we can easily see, this is autocorrelation function of x or x of tau. The second term is autocorrelation function of y or y of tau. This is cross correlation function of x and y or x y of tau. This is cross correlation function of y and x or y x of tau. Okay, so this is your r z of tau. When you add two random processes, this is what happens to their corresponding autocorrelation function. Now if x and y are general processes, you don't know about their interdependence, so it means you have z of t is equal to x of t plus y of t. It is only given that x and y are wide sense stationary and they are jointly stationary. See, I'm able to write here rx y of tau because they are jointly stationary. Okay, then this is the equation. Now in addition to this, if we assume that x of t and y of t are uncorrelated, I recall the definition of uncorrelated. So any two random variables x and y are uncorrelated if expected value of x and y are is equal to expected value of x times expected value of y. This will make its covariance zero. Now it means if x t and y of t are uncorrelated, so expected value of x of t y of t plus tau will be equal to expected value of x of t expected value of y of t plus tau. But we are assuming they are wide sense stationary, hence their mean remains constant. So this expected value of x of t, let me call this as mu x, constant mean, and expected value of y of t plus tau mu y, it doesn't depend upon time. Similarly, expected value of x of so we have the second term is y of t times x of t plus tau. So this will be equal to, because they are assumed to be uncorrelated, so it will be expected value of y of t expected value of x of t plus tau. Now they are wide sense stationary process, so whether you compute y at you compute mean of y at t or t plus tau, mean is same mu y. Similarly, you computed the mean of x of t at time t or t plus tau, it is mu x, which can be written as mu x mu y. So it means that this r x y or r y x, they are same for uncorrelated processes. So r x y of tau is same as r y x of tau, which is same as the mean of x of t times mean of y of t, which is constant. So suppose x mean and y mean, which also I can write as mu x mu y. Okay, so hence we can write the autocorrelation function of output process as autocorrelation function of, you know, x of tau, then autocorrelation function of y of tau plus x mean y mean plus x mean y mean, which is equal to 2x mean y mean. This is very important expression, and in particular you will observe that in communication system, most of the processes are assumed to be having zero mean. Okay, mean is just a bias. Okay, so we can always shift. So either if x mean is zero or y mean is zero or even both are zero, then this expression becomes very, very nice expression, very simple, that the autocorrelation is just add up, right? And hence we can immediately draw inference about power spectral density. Suppose, sorry, it is here R of B. So if I take Fourier transform from the both sides, okay, then I will get Fourier transform of Rz, which is Sz of omega power spectral density of the Z, is equal to power spectral density of one process plus power spectral density of other process. So power spectral density is get added up. Okay, so we have done very important concepts of multiple random process today, and in next lecture I will give some examples which will make the concepts more clear. Thank you.